everyone, and welcome to Day in Life, the Agro, and I'm from the Tokuma channel. Today's now March 2nd, second video log for today, and I was talking about painting and drywall and mudwork and stencils and stuff like that. Anyway, today's plan is going to be, today's plan is going to be about doing some more mudding and sanding and trying to fix everyone's ceiling part and retaping certain areas. And give it a different color. It used to be like a lime green, like a bright lime green. Back way back then, probably when I was about 3 or 4. I actually remember the kitchen color. I actually seen pictures too, but kind of reminds me of that memory. It was a darker green back then. My dad's mom loved the darker greens or the greens in the kitchen, and this was like a little bit darker pea green, like corn, peas and corns, you know. So not to that, she's got like a lime green, not bright lime green, but lime green in her kitchen and her living room. In one bedroom, what is still pink. It's my aunt's. And the other bedroom was, you know, like a light purple, like a violet purple. And then the other bedroom, I think, is still a light blue. And that used to be the one cousins comes to my house, or my place in the city, and comes and goes. And so, but anyway, it's going to be a change. The color's going to be changed now. It's going to be purple throughout the kitchen and the living room. I think it's a kitchen and living room is going to be the same color like it was before. And that's fine now. There's no divider there now to divide the kitchen and the living room, which is supposed to be the kitchen, little small dining room corner, and then the living room, but there's not really much of an issue for a dining corner. You can have your table in the kitchen. It's big enough for that. But it seems like a little bit of work, you know. But there's just three of us, you know, doing stuff like that. And I think that's what the plan is today. If it's not going to be doing any kind of repairs and stuff like that now, might be shopping instead. So I might be shopping today. Most likely be shopping tomorrow. And that's when I'm going to do on the corn soup thing. But yeah, it should be solid. I mean, they probably have solid right now in that fridge. But then let's talk about the preparation of corn soup. I've never really seen any kind of video of anybody talking about how our native corn soup is actually made. Some people make it differently. They only cook at a certain time, and it's not as thick as it should be. Some people, you know, like to overcook things and have a nice dark brown. The traditional one is, you know, like in between, but there's ashes, you know, that falls into the thing. And then when it's distributed out to different people in the small bowls, they actually get like a taste. People are lucky to get maybe maybe 4 tablespoons, maybe, per person. It all depends on how big this pot is and how many they're making, or how many people are actually making that stuff. But for home, we usually make a lot of corn soup to feed at least 16 people, even though there's only 3 of us here, because, you know, corn soup can last for a few days at least before being freeze, because that's what we want to do, you know, put it in the bag. And you need to do enough for like a normal size bowl and Ziploc sandwich bags. So, preparation. Now, back then there used to be always just one big pot, and that's what we had. We didn't really have many pots, but now we have 2 big pots. So let's fill up this one big pot. I mean, the pot is like that wide and that tall. I don't know if the camera can see that, but it's the black and white speckled pot. And it's got a giant lid in there. So planning as well. I done this last year too. I did corn soup last year. A quarter of that pot, because there's so much whiteness in there, so a quarter of that pot of water. Throw your kidney beans in there, and then throw your salt pork in there. And then the other pot, you want to throw your lied corn and some more salt pork on that side, because my dad has the regular salt pork, and I have the non-salted pork. Reason why we're breaking them down two pots is because it is such a big pot, and we don't have so much weight in the one pot, and it pushes it down, and then stuff will sit on the bottom and start burning. Normally, you can do corn soup with two kidney beans. That you can do the regular kidney beans, you can do the red kidney beans, you can do the dark red kidney beans, and you can do the lied corn and some other kind of corn, which is like two different kinds, and then salt pork, non-salt pork. Some people put ham in there or bacon, but you know, salt pork is what's supposed to be in there, and for me, I don't really like a lot of salt. So we got enough to like three, I guess you'd say it's like 2 pounds. If you put three packages together, it's probably 2 pounds right there. And it's now it's split between the two pots. So you gotta cut up your salt pork, and you wanna cut them smaller, because if you got a lot of people that, you know, going to have your corn soup, you don't want them scooping up a lot more meat, because they'll get that salt pork more. So if they're smaller, then they're hard to actually pick it out and, you know, different stuff. Because people bring out ingredients instead of more liquid. And the reason why, you know, this quarter pot, because once it goes into the thing, it'd be like half pot. But I'm thinking about it, I might need more water. I think I'm going to do half pot, because it will boil down to between half pot and quarter pot. So you got to cut up how much time I got here. So you want to cut up your salt pork into like little small things. I don't know how small you could say. How could you measure that? Maybe quarter inch cubic chunks. And split them both into two pots. It'll bring your time down, cooking time, because sometimes I'm cooking up to 6 hours on just one pot, because I'm putting the ingredients in there different ways. So, when you break it down to two pots, then you can cook it for the 2 hours. If you're doing two pots, it'll take 2 hours. If you're doing just one pot, it'll be 4 hours. I mean, that's not bad, too. But what you want to do, you want to make sure the kidney beans are cooked in there for at least 2 hours, because they'll split and then fall apart a little bit. And you want them to at least split. Falling apart, cooking them past that, it would be thicker soup and, you know, tastier and stuff. So the corn stuff, it also gets soft too. And my dad sometimes buy it frozen, or he doesn't buy it frozen. This time, late last night, we went to go check on it. We got 2 bags of corn. And it's a lot of corn. So we were doing 6 cans of dark red kidney beans and 2 of these big bags of, I think it's called lied corn, some kind of corn anyway. And I put 3 cans kidney beans here, 3 can kidney beans there, and then 1 bag of lied corn there, lied corn there, and then put in the salt pork or non-salt pork, the half and half in each one there, and then you got your ingredients mixing up like that. Now, what is good is that your kidney beans will get the flavor into the corn itself, and they'll make your soup thicker. And last year, I think I did it for 3 hours because I wasn't really satisfied on the kidney beans not being, it's not cooked all the way, that, you know, for it to split. Now you can wait till it does split, or you can wait till it like starts to peel off, and you make a thicker soup, and the thicker the better. Some people like to pour their flavors out and just have a plain corn soup thing that's done and stuff, or less kidney beans, more water, you know. to know those ingredients. But I'm thinking about, you know, probably around half pot each, because they're like wide pots. They're wide pots. There's like a big giant lid on them too. So that's the process, you know. You could be doing 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, or whatever, you know, size of the pot and how much ingredients you got on there, or in there, I mean. That's usually how it is. And then last year's, I mean, there's still a package of corn soup from last year, and that was on end of summer that I'm doing. I mean, it's still good. So that won't be today, that'll be tomorrow. Might be doing the painting stuff pretty soon, then shopping tomorrow, and then doing that corn soup, and you know, just well enough time, because we're going to be going to do shopping on 2, be done by 4, start doing all that stuff, and I'm about 7 or 8 tomorrow night. But I mean, that's how you make corn soup, and to make scones, everybody makes your scones different. It's one of those things, see if I got some time here. Everybody makes their scones different. Some days they make the little scone biscuits. And that's the thing too with the word. When you look at the word scone, some people spell it with an E. Doesn't it look like scone? I mean, it sounds different. I mean, the scone is something like English style instead of, you know, scone. And I think they just, everybody's got to keep dropping that E off so it looks like, say, scone. Because so many people just put E in there. It's not scone, it's scone. And some people do cup style. Sometimes they do a little bit like bowl style. Sometimes they do like a wide cake pan style. Sometimes they do like a thick pancake, you know, thick pancake style, and the oil itself, and you know, how much oil in there, how long you cook it for, and stuff like that. My dad's done microwave style. So everybody does it differently, you know, put a little sugar in there, do it with buttermilk, don't do it with buttermilk, and everybody does their scones differently. And BC, I guess they call it bannocks. So I'm at the end of this video now, so if you guys do like this video, please use the like button. Please subscribe to me. And share this video on channel my benefit, my benefit me. Please do tell your friends and family. Thank you for your time, guys. Watch it. Hope you all have a nice day, morning, night. And remember, it's better to be Aboriginal than original. Oh, hey.